I'm world famous. Tonight, I can see. You realize that they're in a MacRubber theater and not in a cemetery. Now, it's a great personality to be up here in Scotland. In fact, it's 24 years since I was last here. I came, I was living in Birmingham then, I played rugby for the Birmingham Welsh, and we came up to Murrayfield. And I'll never forget that day. Welcome we had. And I also remember going on that little train that you had going from the end of Prince's Street to Murrayfield. And we're there in an open compartment singing hymns as we usually do. And there's a little man standing there. And I looked down and so he must have been small. I'm 5 foot something and he was 5 foot nothing. And he had a cloth cap on and an old overcoat. And he had Welsh written all over him. And whilst we were singing, he was looking out through the window, and tears were rolling down his face. Oh, I felt sorry for him. I thought he probably had to come up here during the Depression, and didn't manage to get back home to Wales very often. So I went up to him and I said, how long is it since you left Wales?
Last Thursday.
We always have a welcome in Scotland. There is something between the two nations in there. There is some affinity, some friendship. That we'll see September 30 tomorrow. I always notice as well there's a likeness in the scenery in both countries, isn't there? And I noticed this on the way up, you know, we left Wales and its beautiful mountains, and then we came through England. Which is flat and uninteresting. And then we came... And chatting to a farmer, he said, tell me, guy, he said, I've travelled all over England and down in Wales, and I noticed one thing, that whilst England is comparatively flat here in Wales, you have these beautiful mountains. Tell me, what accounts for this?
Well, it's quite easy, really, sir.
We fought the English on quite a few occasions, and we've won every time. In fact, we've won that much land that in the end we ever started. Sense of the word world famous. Not only have they sung in concerts all over Wales, they've also sung in the Albert Hall. They've been here in Scotland, in this very hall 4 years ago, and that must have been a success because we can see that from the number of people in the audience tonight. They've also been to Germany twice, and they've also been to Canada. They have competed 8 times in the national endeavor. They've come second on 6 occasions. And on 3 of those occasions, they came within 1 point of winning the first prize. And I am told from very reliable sources that the winners of the Chief Male Voice competition at the National Royal National Estella de Macintosh in 1981 will be Sanity. Please give them a very warm welcome. Maybe. Monty, and I'm sure that the choir, as well as you, are very grateful that he's been able to meet this trip. Give a very warm welcome to John Levy. but I never expected the welcome I'd had this time. You know, I went up to Stirling Castle this afternoon, and as soon as I arrived, they fired a 21 gun. But I'm always sad when I visit castles, you know, because there was one occasion when the English beat us and they conquered a Welsh castle. And all I can say is they must have had a better pack then. Do you know what they did? They shot all the men and they kept the only two women there alive. Lovewin and Mulvaney. And life was very hard for them. And they couldn't escape. There was a moat all the way around the castle full of crocodiles. But one day Mulvaney decided she'd had enough. So she jumped right down into the moat, swam right through the crocodiles, they never touched her, and all the soldiers were watching her. But when she got to the other side, they said, "Mavanui, how did you manage to get through?" Mavanui turned round, and on a t-shirt she had written, "Scotland will beat Wales at Murrayfield." And not even a crocodile would swallow that. Kids that I got through their 11th class, trying to think of any counsellors that might be on the other side. But he didn't have worried because when he finally arrived at the pearly gate, they were wide open. And he walked in, and the first person that came round the corner was the devil. And he said, well, I've come to the wrong gate. No, said the devil. We've gone all comprehensive. Now, I don't know how we elect school teachers around here, but down in South Wales, there's a panel of councillors that do it. And Clinethy have recently gone comprehensive, and they're selecting a head of music in a comprehensive school. And one of the people on the shortlist was a fellow with a degree in zoology. And one of the questions that the councillor asked him was, "Tell me, my man, what do you know about Beethoven?" Well, he said, I've got to be honest, if you'd asked me that question yesterday, I would not have been able to answer it. But as it so happened, I was travelling on the quarter to 9 bus from Kidwelly, a little village outside Llanelli. I was travelling on the quarter to 9 bus from Kidwelly this morning. And there was only one vacant seat, and I sat next to this revered old gentleman with a beard and a straw hat. And to pass the time a bit, I said, "I haven't seen you around here before." "No," he said, "and in case you're curious, my name is Beethoven, the composer." And he said, and then he went on telling me how he composed his masterpieces. And he told the councillors all this. And in fact, I'm going to tell you tonight, quite interesting, actually. And after he'd gone out, the chairman of the councillors turned round to the rest. And he said, "Gentlemen, I wouldn't believe a word that fellow is saying. And I tell you why. The quarter to 9 from Kidwelly." The idea of me make a job like this is not to make this into a variety show, but indeed to give the choir a well-deserved rest. I think they've had the rest now, so welcome back.
See that sister dress so religion on her mind.
See that brother dressed so gay?
Devil's gonna come and carry him away.
Oh, the old ducks are moving in the mover, in the mover, in the old ducks are moving by the spirit of God. Oh, the old ducks are moving in the mover, in the mover, in the old ducks are moving, and thank God.
Shopping about a fortnight before the wedding, and a little mine on the wedding. And she went across the Kingsway, didn't look left or right, and a car came, gone up. Poor Dad, he only lasted 3 weeks after he died of a broken heart. But I met in heaven, and they decided to get married. They went to see Peter and they said, "We want to get married." And he said, "Yes, yes. I'll put your name down on the waiting list." Waiting was this early? Yeah, we haven't had a minister of religion here for years. People often ask me, and I like in a serious face when I tell these jokes. Don't you realise I've heard them before? And you know, whenever this choir have a dinner, there's always a vicar or a minister of religion there to say grace. So they went to one dinner and he hadn't turned up. And they're all sitting there and their soup was getting cold. 5 minutes, 10 minutes. So they asked one of the boys to say grace. And he got up and he said, "For heaven's sake, let's eat." So you can see we've got quite a few practice in this choir. Would you like to meet one or two of them? Would you? Now then, boys. Like doing the balls of it. What's your biggest talker yet?
Thank you. And he was the favourite pupil of whom?
From Eddie.
Somebody else here as well says that he was the favourite from Eddie. And he, like yourself, doesn't know that I'm going to stop and talk to him. Next one. What position did you use to hear the name first?
The Graham Jeffries.
What position did you use to play for tonight again?
Hooker.
I heard another little whisper about you as well. You came very close to the international honours, didn't you?
Yes. I was 23 times reserve for Wales.
Say what it's ready. and see what's on his back.
How long have you been the chairman of the choir now?
About 15 years.
And when did the choir start?
About 16 years ago. Uh-huh.
And you were a founding member?
One of the founding members, yeah.
How did the choir start? You know, bearing in mind that there are so many, you know, boys' choirs down in your part.
Well, half a dozen of the boys met in a sound chapel in Vignette, and they thought they'd have a little glee party of about 20 strong. The end result is 140.
And you've got members of the same family in the choir, haven't you?
Yes, I have. I have a brother, Byron, who's in the first case with me here. Also have a brother who's a registrar of the Pointed Lice, Bill Boy Squire. We're still friends. We have a very busy program for the 1981 also. We're fully prepared for 1982 as well. So we hope we don't have too many requests from Scotland for 1982 anyway. But from the, we'd like to come back and say 1983. March 28th, the concert at Tregaron, Mid Wales. May 24th, Pontypridd, Bingo, and Stillford. June 27th, Cardigan, and Stillford. July 25th, concert at the Great Hall, Exeter University. That is the Great Hall, yes, that's right. And the Royal National, we will be there, as you did say. And on the 13th then of September, concert at the Brangwen Hall, Swansea. October the 3rd, Moyners of Stillford Call. October the 17th, concert at the Royal Festival Hall, London. November the 21st, annual concert at the Netty Entertainment Centre. December the 5th, concert at Birmingham Town Hall. And December the 19th, carol concert at the Netty.
And if you can come to them all, you'll be here. So you can see, in fact, that this is quite a talented choir. Somebody told me once that the sort of talents that we have in life depends on where you're kissed by the Almighty when you were born. For example, if you're kissed on the forehead, you'll be a great intellect. If you're kissed on the hand, you'll be a great pianist or an artist. If you're kissed on your feet, you'll be somebody like Phil Bennett, or possibly the next one to him, Andy Irvin. And I tell you quite honestly, I don't know where the Almighty kissed Neville, but all the boys tell me that he's an excellent chairman.
house for sale. Overlooking a nudist colony. The owner is selling due to failing eyesight. Now the clerk can come all this way from South Wales without seeing Field in well. Just as a point of interest, why don't you have your speed power? Thank you.
No.
walked out in every little village in Wales. And some people had great difficulty with the Welsh language. I remember going to one little village shop, and they just had a new bacon slice. And they didn't have enough room for it on the counter, so they put it on a little table. You know what people are like in village shops? They come in, chatting, sitting on the table. And the bacon slicer was always breaking down. The shopkeeper now put a notice on it. Please don't sit on a bacon slicer, as we are getting behind in our order. But in every one of these villages, you always had the expert, one expert in the English language. And invariably, it was the reporter of the local paper, you know, the weekly paper. And they had one of these in a little village called Bryn Aman. Now, there'd been a funeral in Bryn Aman on a very, very wet day. And as they were carrying the coffin into the cemetery, one of the bearers slipped and broke his leg. And the report in the paper the following week was, during the funeral service of Mr. John John, one of the bearers slipped and broke his leg. This unfortunate accident brought gloom over the proceedings.
shore, I will return once more. Aye, 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 aye. Down in the forest, deep in the lowlands, my heart cries out for the hills of the north. Blue lake and rocky shore, I will return once more. Aye, 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 aye. On the rocky ledge I'll build a wigwam, close by the water's edge, silent and still. Blue lake and rocky shore, I will return once more. Aye, 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 aye.
I am I'm an Irishman, oh yeah, look at him. Right, Doc, he said, carry on with the operation. So he did the operation, he went to see him. He said, now everything's going to be right, you're going to be fine. He said, you're going to be fine. But I've got to tell you one thing, that due to the way that your brain is formed, it was impossible for me to take 40% weight. He said, I'm sorry, but I have to take 60% weight. And the American turned around and said, that's all right for you, don't worry at all about it.
Norm out there, he had a meeting with his father, just the two of them.
his father's head. He's the only son. What is England like? It is a very beautiful country, father. Very beautiful country. And what are the people like? They are very nice people, father. And are they very religious? Yes, father. They have many religions. Well, please tell me about them. Well, they've got Church of England, Roman Catholic, Wesleyan, Methodist, Congregationalist, and Bingo. Well, son, I have heard about the first five, but I have not heard about Bingo. Please tell me about Bingo. Well, you see, father, every Sunday night, they go into this very big chapel called Mecca. And when they go in, they are given a little hymn book with a lot of music. And you have the preacher in front of the congregation with a box full of little balls with numbers on it.
Thank you.
sing in the only language of song he sang. He said the third thing, sing something that people know. Can you just imagine the scene now? Right hand in front of the Grand Piano. And I'm singing in Italian in the Cafe Riot. One word of advice. Never sing in Italian in a cafe in Ponte Reves. Now, Nikolai Anshkov said that if you do those three things, you needn't even voice the song. In fact, it'd be far better if you don't, because you'll let the imagination of the audience take over.
Amen.
said he couldn't say things. Well, I'm very pleased to be here, but I'm sure you're not. You're not going to But I can sincerely say that of all the audiences I've appeared before, you were most definitely the best.
Ursula.
Mm. Do you really not want to get married?
I don't know. Depends how you mean.
Usually means one thing.
Wouldn't you be in a better position if you were married? Might be. I'm not sure, really.
You don't think one needs the experience of having been married?
Oh, Gudrun, do you really think it need be an experience?
It's bound to be, possibly undesirable, but it is bound to be an experience of some sort.
Not really. More likely to be the end of experience.
Morning, Miss Franklin.
Morning.
Yes, of course, there is that to consider.
Timmy, for God's sake! There we are, late. Here. Got it?
No, never forget it.
What?
Gerald's going to blame me for this, you know?
Yes.
Where's Birkin?
With the groom, he's late.
Charming there.
Thank you.
Good morning, Christiana.
It's a bad form for the groom to be late. Gerald will be furious.
Oh, don't worry about that. Something unconventional will do that family good. Laura's not going to run away, you know. Now, if you're late, you're late.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Father? Hello, Laura.
Timmy!
What a spectacle.
Does it hurt your sense of family pride?
Yes, it does, rather. Do something properly or don't bother to do it at all.
But it's a masterpiece of good form. It's the hardest thing in the world to act spontaneously on one's impulses, and it's the only gentlemanly thing to do, provided you're fit enough to do it.
Do you expect me to take you seriously?
Yes.